Welcome to the first experiment of electrical machines. Here we are going to explain the no load and load test on DC shunt generator. As the name suggests that under the no load test, we will not put any load, and in the load test, we will put the load and then we will do the test on DC shunt generator. Why it is called DC shunt generator? Because the field winding is connected in parallel with the armature. Now, first we will look the panel and then we will see the connection. Since DC shunt generator will require a DC supply, so the AC supply will be converted to DC. So here in the panel, the first supply will come as 3-phase 415 volt frequency 50 Hz. Which will be converted to DC using a thyristor. So this DC supply will be changed slowly with respect to this knob. Then let us look into the panel. So all measuring instruments are digital, which are connected at the top. So these digital instruments having voltmeter and ammeter, they are all DC measuring instruments. Now, the voltmeter and ammeters are again of different types. So, voltmeter here will measure the armature voltage, and here we are going to measure the generator voltage. The field current, we are going to measure the armature current and the field current. So, if we look into the panel, we see that M indicates the motor and G indicates the generator. Both motor and generator are mechanically coupled with respect to each other so that it can rotate at the same speed. Now, the rating of the motor is written on the left hand top. So, this is DC shunt motor, 3.7 kilowatt power rating, 220 volt voltage, 1500 rpm as the rated speed. On the right hand side, if you see, here it is written DC shunt generator whose rating is 3.5 kilowatt, that is the power rating, 220 volt, that is the rated voltage, and 1500 rpm, that is the rated current. So both motor and generator, which are mechanically coupled with respect to each other, will rotate at the same speed, that is 1500 rpm as the rated speed. Now this motor and generator, in parallel, we have the field winding connected. This field winding is connected in parallel, hence the name suggests as DC shunt generator. Now, the motor acts as the input to the generator, which is driving the generator. And the output of the generator can be under the no load condition, or there is a load we have, that is the resistive load that we will be connecting to vary the voltage and the current. Here, there is the nameplate details of the motor and the generator being written. So, the kilowatt rating of the motor is 3.5 kilowatt, voltage 220 volt, current 18.6 ampere. So, 18.6 ampere is the rated current. Rated current means we should not go above 18.6 ampere for the motor. Then the speed is 1500 rpm. Excitation current, that is the field current, is 0.95 ampere and the winding type is shunt. On the DC shunt generator end, it is 3.5 kilowatt motor, 220 volt. The rated current of generator is 16 ampere. So, we should not cross 16 ampere on the generator side. The rated speed is 1500 rpm and the excitation current here also is 0.9 ampere. Both generator and motor are of shunt type, hence the field windings are connected in parallel. Now, the armature resistance of the motor and the generator is 0.7 and 1.4 ohm respectively, whereas the shunt field resistance is 188 ohms for the motor and 185 ohms for the generator. This information has to be written in the observation table, the nameplate details of both the generator and the motor. Then we will look the circuit connection. We will do the circuit connection and take the readings. So under the no load test, we are going to take the reading of field current with respect to the generated voltage, that is the no load voltage. And under the load test, one by one, we will keep on increasing the load and then we will take the readings of voltage and the current. Now here one thing has to be noted, that all the reading has to be done at the rated speed, that is 1500 RPM. Moreover, whenever you will increase the load, then you will see that the speed falls for the generator. So here we have to maintain that speed in every reading. So now we will start the connection. So first, the input will come from the positive end of the DC supply. Then it will go to the voltmeter of the DC motor. The positive end of the voltmeter will be connected to the positive end of the DC motor. The negative end of the ammeter is connected to the armature of the motor. The negative DC supply is connected to the negative of the voltmeter. Again, the negative of the supply is connected to the negative of the armature. The field winding of the motor is connected to the supply. The other end of the rheostat of the field motor is connected to the field winding, Z terminal. The negative of the field supply is connected to the other end, ZZ, of the field winding of the motor. Now we'll start the connection for the generator. So the armature of the generator is connected to the positive supply of the measuring voltage. The other end of the armature is connected to the field rheostat of the generator. The other end of the rheostat of the generator is connected to the field ammeter of the motor. The negative end of the ammeter of the motor is connected to the field winding of the generator. The negative voltage of the generator is connected to the other end terminal of the generator, of the armature. The armature of the generator terminal is connected to the field ZZ terminal of the generator. Now we have two knob, one for the motor that is kept to be minimum and one knob for the generator which has to be kept to the maximum. There is a knob of the supply, DC supply, which is kept at zero. Now we will turn on the MCB. So once we turn on the MCB, next we are going to turn on the switch of the field of the motor. Now the panel has turned on, so I will start the on supply. Once we are on the supply, the reading will start as soon as we turn the knob of the DC supply. Now we'll slowly increase the DC supply and we will note the readings which is displayed on the panel. The knob will be turned slowly and we will keep an eye on the measuring instrument till a rated voltage of the shunt motor 220 volt is reached. So we see that 220 volt has reached in the motor end. Now the speed of the generator has to be close to 1500 rpm, so which we are going to do that by turning the field rheostat of the motor. As we can see that the speed of the generator and the motor, which is 1500 rpm, is increasing. We have to measure at the rated speed, that is 1500 rpm. So once the speed has reached to 1500 rpm, we will turn the knob from the maximum point of the generator to slowly we will change and revolve it so that the field voltage of the generator has come down. Now we will take the reading. The reading will be taken between the field current and the generated voltage. So here we can see that the field current is 0.12 ampere and the generated voltage is 55 volt. Now again we are going to turn the knob of the field rheostat of the generator and further note down the reading of the generated voltage and the field current. So the field current here is 0.22 ampere and the field voltage is 90 volt. Again we are going to turn the knob of the DC shunt generator field and further note down the reading of the field current, which is 0.36 ampere and the field generated voltage, that is 138 volt. Keep on revolving the knob of the DC shunt generator and note down the other readings. Now the reading is come to be 0.47 ampere field current and 168 volt generated voltage. Keep on revolving the knob of the DC shunt generator field and measure the generated voltage and the field current. The field current is 0.65 ampere and the voltage is 198 volt. Now other readings we are going to take by turning the field rheostat. Now the reading is 0.84 ampere at a voltage of 220 volt. So the rated voltage of the DC shunt generator has reached now. The reading has to be taken at a rating of 20% of the rated voltage of the generator. So the rated voltage is 220 volt. So 20% of 220 volt, we have to take the reading. By turning the knob of the field rheostat, we can observe the generated voltage to turn and change. So here we can observe that the field current is 1.08 ampere and 20% of the rated voltage, that is 240 volt, has reached now. So further reading up to 260 volt and 1.44 ampere has reached for the readings of the generator voltage and the field current. Now, the first reading that we have taken is in the forward direction of the field with respect to the generated voltage. Now, we will take the reading in the reverse direction. So, turning the knob of the DC shunt generator field rheostat, we are measuring the field voltage, that is 238, and the field current to be 0.97. After taking the reading, we are going to turn off the panel, but before that, certain precaution has to be taken. The generator rheostat has to be kept at the maximum point by turning on the knob, and the motor field rheostat has to be kept at the minimum point by turning on the knob. Then keep the knob of the supply at the minimum point, that is the zero point. We will observe that slowly the motor has turned off. Now we are going to press the off switch of the panel. Now turn off the MCV and close the meter. Now we are going to perform the load test on DC shunt generator. So we have a resistive load there. So this resistive load we can change one by one to the rating of 1 ampere onwards. And before we have done no load test. So compared to the no load test, only two connections will change. One, we will connect an ammeter to the field armature, and one, we are going to connect the load. So the armature of the generator is connected to the positive end of the generator. Now the load terminal is connected. So the positive of the load is connected to the negative of the generator. The negative of the load is connected to the field resistance. So terminal ZZ. Now we are going to turn on the panel. So first turn on the MCB. Then turn on the switch on. Then turn on the meter. So we can see the meter readings. So turn on the knob and start the motor generator set. Turn on the knob slowly . Now we can see the humming noise of the motor generator set. The knob has to be turned such that the rated voltage of the shunt motor is reached. Now we have to note the speed of the generator. So speed of the generator has to reach 1500 RPM, that is the rated speed of the generator. This can be achieved by turning the knob of the field rheostat of the motor. So once the 1500 RPM is reached, now we are going to turn on the knob of the field rheostat of the motor. The field rheostat of the generator is turned slowly and the rated voltage of the generator is reached. Now, one by one, increase the load from the resistive end. So, turn on the load once. As soon as we are turning the load, we will see that speed of the generator falls. So we will keep that in the rated speed by turning on the rheostat knob of the motor. Now once it is reached to the rated speed, that is 1500 RPM, we have to note the field current of the generator and the field current of the motor. So the line current, that is IL, VL is the load voltage, and we have to note the field current. So we can see from the panel that the line current is 1.83 ampere and the line voltage is 217 volt and the field current is 0.83 ampere of the motor. Now again, increase the load from the resistive load. So once we increase the load, we will see that the speed will change. Now we have to maintain that in the rated speed by turning the rheostat of the motor. By turning the rheostat, the rated speed of 1500 rpm has to be reached. So once we maintain the rated speed, now we are going to take the reading of the line voltage, that is 214 volt, line current 3.57 ampere and the field current of the motor, that is 0.81 ampere. Further increase the load and then again the same thing will happen. There will be a change in the speed of the generator, which can be kept to 1500 rpm by turning the knob of the motor rheostat. So once the 1500 rpm is maintained, then you have to record the line voltage, line current and the field current of the motor. Here we can note that the line voltage is 210 volt, line current is 5.25 ampere and the field current is 0.79 ampere for the motor. We have to take the reading close to the rated current of the generator. We have seen that the rated current of the generator is 16 ampere. So we have to take the reading up to 14 ampere. Now once we 14 ampere is reached for the rated current of the generator, we will see that the rated current of the motor will increase. Now increase the load so that the current of the generator is reached to 14 ampere. Now we can note that the current has to be reached 14 ampere by changing the rheostat and kept the rated speed to be 1500 rpm. So the current has reached to 14 ampere, which is close to 16 ampere, that is the rated speed of the rated current of the generator. Now note down the line current, line voltage and the field current. Once all the reading is over, before turning off this panel, we have to go in the reverse direction. Turn off the load one by one till all the load are turned off. Now turn the knob of the field rheostat of the generator and keep it to the maximum point. The motor rheostat will be turned to the minimum point. Now rotate and turn the knob of the supply so that the motor generator set is switched off. Now turn off the supply and turn off the MCV. Switch off the meter. This completes the load test on DC shunt generator.